Championship. He's going to headline WrestleMania. WrestleMania is going to be all about The Miz.
And of course, we'll also find out this Sunday who will challenge whoever is the WWE Champion in an Elimination Chamber match.
Look, you've main evented WrestleMania in the past. You know what it's like to have that opportunity. I mean, what does it feel like knowing you're going to go into that event, being in the main event?
I mean, come on, Cole. I mean, butterflies. I mean, you're worried, you're scared at the same time. But WrestleMania starts way before that for us. I mean, we're working all year to get to that spot in WrestleMania. It really can't even be described.
Cover here by Kofi Kingston, hooks the outside leg.
Alex Riley showing some concern at ringside.
Yeah, you have to wonder if The Miz is regretting coming here to SmackDown tonight and taking this match against Kofi Kingston.
Why would Miz regret that?
Because I think he thought this was going to be a warm-up for him, and it's not.
Get him out. Let's go.
I think Miz is smart enough to know, Book, that no match in WWE is a warm-up, so to speak.
I mean, when you're as arrogant as The Miz, I think you can think that.
And Kofi Kingston going to another level. High crossbody. Miz is down. Miz is out. He got him.
Death three count.
And again, The Miz just showing the wherewithal, the guts, the heart, the kick out.
Nice counter here by Miz.
Oh! Wow! That was a great move.
That's vintage Miz.
And this may do it. Miz with the cover.
That's what Miz has totally excelled. I mean, he has brought his game up. I mean, I can look at him and tell he's been working on his game.
Well, he is the WWE Champion.
See, I appreciate, Booker, that you like The Miz for his athletic ability and what he does in ring competition. Cole, you like the guy because of his ego and his arrogance.
Yeah, I think he's great in the ring as well. He's the WWE Champion, and he's cool.
He's cool?
Yeah.
Look at the innovation by Kofi Kingston.
Kingston. Ooh! Big punch right there.
This is where Kofi will look to feed off the energy here from the WWE Universe.
He's going to do it. Drop.
Boom drop from Kofi Kingston.
He's feeling it right now. He's on his toes. I think he just got his second win.
Hey! Alberto Del Rio, the Royal Rumble match winner.
Oh, what are you doing here?
There's been a little bit of history over the past few weeks between Alberto Del Rio
and Kofi Kingston. A lot of history. A whole lot of history.
Alberto Del Rio has
big right hand.
So the initial shock of seeing Alberto Del Rio perhaps wearing off for Kofi Kingston as Kofi back to the task at hand.
Hey!
And Alberto Del Rio.
Come on. I mean, how can you work like this with distractions like this? Come on. Kofi had this match won.
Listen again, guys. You can say you believe Kofi had the match won, but the bottom line at the end of the day is this. On Monday, The Miz beat the United States champion Daniel Bryan. Tonight he beat the Intercontinental Champion Kofi Kingston.
He did not beat Kofi Kingston.
Well, here's how it all went down right here, and you can judge for yourself as Alberto Del Rio would cause the distraction.
Yeah, he lost the match. But he didn't beat him. That's the way I see it.
Well, I'm watching the replay, and I just saw Miz deliver
the same thing. Like I said, he lost the match, but he didn't beat him. All right? You get an every win, one-on-one, fair and square, then you can beat somebody.
Hey, Booker, you take your eye off the ball, just strike out.
What?
Alberto Del Rio was embarrassed last week here on SmackDown by Kofi Kingston. Del Rio will challenge the World Heavyweight Champion at WrestleMania. What a night it's been, ladies and gentlemen. This is, of course, the 600th episode of SmackDown. Wow. Guys, it's just absolutely incredible where this puts us all time for the longest-running weekly episodic television shows. Here is Cole Booker, the top 10 list.
Well, number 10, My Three Sons, of course, starring the very famous Fred McMurray. Number nine was Bonanza. I believe JR started that show for a number of years. Ozzy and Harriet, of course, at number eight. Death Valley Days, who narrated by Merle Haggard, by the way. Death Valley Days coming in at number seven. At number six, Law and Order, which was on the air for some 20 seasons. At number five, of course, The Simpsons. Bart doesn't stand a chance, however, against Friday Night SmackDown. Poor Lassie. Lassie's now roadkill because SmackDown is zoomed past Lassie into number three. Third place in counting. Next on the list, the next people going down, Gunsmoke, James Arness, Dennis Weaver, Burt Reynolds. Thanks for coming. Kenny and Marshall Dillon going to have their funeral because SmackDown is heading for Gunsmoke. And, of course, number one, the longest-running weekly episodic television show in history.
That's your show, right, buddy?
My show, Monday Night Raw.
That was entertaining. You did a good job.
That actually was a good job.
Booker, what else we got going on tonight?
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up, World Championship coronation of Dolph Ziggler coming up later tonight here on Friday Night SmackDown.
You're excited.
I can feel it.
Coming up next, the WWE Tag Team Champions are in action on the 600th episode of SmackDown. Will Santino Marella unleash the Cobra, or will Gabriel and Slater continue to take out the champions? We'll find out next on the 600th SmackDown.
You and I have been around SmackDown for a very long time. Whenever I think of SmackDown, I think of Eddie Guerrero.
Yeah. I think of Eddie also. God rest his soul. He was a great friend of mine, and we will miss him a whole lot for many, many years to come.
Following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Producing first in the ring, the challengers at a combined weight, 459 pounds, Justin Gabriel and Heath Slater, they're members of the Core.
Justin Gabriel and Heath Slater have to be confident about becoming tag team champions here tonight as a result of what took place last week, just leaving and taking out the current reigning tag team champions, Santino Marella and Vladimir Kozlov.
Tell you one thing about the Core, I've been so impressed with guys, it's been their dominance. They have dominated everyone since arriving on the scene here on Friday night. But speaking of dominance.
Yeah, the Core has also been able to equalize and neutralize the largest athlete on the planet, the Big Show.
I mean, come on, they got this muscle, man. They got a lot of muscle on their side, and they're taking advantage of it.
Well, the Core have certainly put Friday Night SmackDown on notice, and just imagine what kind of impact the Core could make if Slater and Gabriel could become tag team champions here tonight.
And what I like about this is Slater and Gabriel come out to the ring on their own. No Wade Barrett, no Ezekiel Jackson.
Yeah, we'll see how long that lasts. We will see.
And at a combined weight of 529 pounds, they're the WWE Tag Team Champions, Vladimir Kozlov and Santino Marella.
Guys, next week here on SmackDown, Wade Barrett can be the World Heavyweight Champion if he's successful in the Elimination Chamber this Sunday. Slater and Gabriel could be Tag Team Champions. The Core could be running SmackDown by this time next week.
Can you imagine?
I know. I can't imagine that.
And what I love about it is the fact that they're four equals. There's no leader. The group are made up of four equals.
Why do you keep saying that?
What?
There's no equals when you got four guys. I mean, what are you talking about? I mean, every quarterback, every football team got a quarterback. Every baseball team got a pitcher. I mean, in this business, it's got to be one man on top running the show.
You know, Booker, I agreed with you last week, but we have seen such equality from the core so far here on SmackDown.
Wow.
They have been an equal unit.
Equality.
Justin Gabriel taken out by...
Wait, look at this.
Vladimir Kozlov in control here.
Well, there you go.
Wait a minute.
Wade Barrett on the right. Ezekiel Jackson on the left.
I mean, Ezekiel Jackson, man, this guy gets you in the alley, you know, coming from the ATM. I mean, you would give him all your money. He wouldn't even have to rob you. You just give it to him.
And now the game plan, the strategy completely changes for the tag team champions, Kozlov and Arella. As Gabriel from behind, the distraction working early.
Distractions.
Yeah, but again, are they doing anything illegal, Book?
They shouldn't even be out here.
But
why are they out here?
Look, I'm not trying to argue.
No, you tell me why are they out here.
Supporting their teammates.
Support.
Can I ask you a question without you jumping all down my throat?
What is it?
Are they doing anything illegal?
Yeah, they're out here. They should not be out here.
I remember
it's a tag team match.
I remember when you were used to have your queen running around here.
My queen was my wife.
Right. By Vladimir Kozlov.
Come on, Santino.
Santino Marella. So the odds now stacked against the tag team champions, but Santino Marella all over Justin Gabriel.
Wait a minute. He just did a split. James Brown. James Brown.
Santino quickly tight cover here, hooks the outside leg.
1972 wants her music reference back.
That's right. He's gonna hit it with it.
Oh, Gabriel down and out.
He got him.
And it's Ezekiel Jackson.
See the, oh my goodness.
Here are the exterminators.
Now you wanna tell me why they're down here now, Cole?
Oh, they're down here now. Oh, look out!
Here comes the Big Show.
The giant.
A romper and a stomping giant.
The giant, the Big Show, taking out Justin Gabriel, taking out Wade Barrett.
Folks, we are in Southern California with
wow. Stumbling, baby.
And now the odds are even.
Big Show's all over these guys right now. There goes one. But then Wade Barrett just took a ride.
Lee Slater may want to try to
Slater see just for the ride. Now Jackson, get in there with the Big Show 101 and show me what you got. I don't think he's mad enough to get in there and do it.
Well, this is what we've been waiting for. Ezekiel Jackson and the Big Show one-on-one.
No, he's looking for some help. He's looking for somebody to back him up.
Big Show seething. Ezekiel Jackson, the smile away from the face of Jackson now.
What'd I tell you?
Ezekiel Jackson, I believe, wanted to get in the ring and take on the Big Show. But he's going to do it when he's ready. Wade Barrett and Gabriel and Slater, both all urging Jackson not to get into the ring. Ezekiel Jackson will face Big Show one-on-one when he's ready on his...